What's up guys, welcome back to my channel. Last week I made a $16,000 debt payment and I just felt like it deserved its own dedicated video. If you're new here, hey, I'm Lauren and my husband and I are working on paying off six-figure student loan debt. And so I post here every single month about our real numbers of our journey to pay off debt along with other personal finance tips and just other stuff that's going on in my life. So if you like content like that, then make sure you hit subscribe to follow along. We have never made a debt payment this big. It actually technically wasn't one payment, it was five payments, but I'll get into that in just a second. But in the matter of 3 days, we paid off $16,311 worth of debt to bring our home equity line of credit balance down to zero. So I'm just so excited about this. I feel so good about it. And I made a video talking about the decision to do this or not do it. And I was kind of going through the pros and cons with you guys. I'll link that video in the description for this video if you want to check it out to hear like my reasoning, my thought process as I was making this decision. But I was pretty much had made my mind up when I made that video, and then the comments were overwhelmingly in support of us doing it, and any concerns that were raised were things that I had already kind of thought about. Personal finance is personal, so the decision to do this was a personal decision. Somebody in my shoes could have done the opposite and it would have also been right, and that's what I love about personal finance, because you can do things different ways and doesn't mean that they're wrong. As long as you're still making smart decisions and working towards making progress in your finances, then you are on the right track. So, what did we do? First of all, one of you had a great suggestion is to call the credit union, because online you can only make a payment of $3,500 maximum. And so I wanted to see what my options were for making payments, because obviously $16,000, we were gonna have to make a lot of payments to get to that amount. So I called the credit union and I asked what's the best way to do it. And they said, get a cashier's check from your bank. Okay, and then drive to our branch and hand it to us. Okay, so I didn't want to do all that, and their branch is like 40 minutes from me, the closest one, and I just didn't want to have to go to two banks and just no. So that was automatically off the table. I was like, I would rather make a payment every day for like 5 days if I need to than drive around to two banks. So the next question I asked is, well, can I make multiple payments in one day? So you can only make a $3,500 payment, but can I make like five of those in a row? And she said you could, but it probably would trigger something in our system and like decline it, because it would think somebody was like accidentally pressing submit multiple times on one payment accidentally, and so they would probably like not accept it because they wouldn't want to charge you like five times for the same amount. But she said, you know, if you varied the amounts and kind of spread it out over a few days, it probably would go through. So that's what I did. I made two payments on Wednesday the 15th, which is the day the video went up, and they were for $3,500 and $3,200, and I did two different amounts because I wanted them to like see that these were not two payments in the same amount, hoping that they would go through, which they did. And then the next day I made a payment for $3,300 and $3,400. So again, two different amounts from each other and from the prior day. And those both went through. And then on Friday, I made one final payment. And right after I made the payment, I got a phone call from the bank and they were like, are you making all these payments? So they did catch on that something was like happening a lot with my account, which is good. I'm glad they're monitoring these things, but I'm glad I also caught their call, because I could tell them like, yes, this is me. I'm trying to pay off this home equity line of credit. Like, please let my payments go through. I don't want to have to like wait for them to undo and then redo them. So they allowed the payments to go through. So on Friday, I made a payment for $2,646.28, which totaled to $16,311.28. So our home equity line is paid off. It is still open. It has a $30,000 limit. So if we need to draw on it again, we can. It has a 4% interest rate, which is variable. And there was an announcement from the Fed last week saying that they are going to raise interest rates 3 times next year. So that rate could go up, but it's still better than a credit card rate. So we are gonna keep it open as long as we have this house, which that's another thing I'll talk to you guys about. Well, we're not selling it right now, but just something I wanna talk to you guys about and my upcoming debt payoff like strategy videos. And so yeah, we have it open still and it's paid off and it feels so good. So we're down to two student loans that we're trying to pay off. Technically, we also have a mortgage, which we are not paying off early because we are planning on selling our house at some point in the next couple years. And then also technically we do have a balance on a credit card that's 0% interest that I could pay off today with our HSA funds, because I put my Invisalign on a card just to like get a 0% interest loan. But yeah, I'm getting into all our debt payoff updates, and this is just supposed to be about the home equity line of credit payoff. But anyway, we technically have the American Express. That's down to under $3,000. It started at over $4,200 for the Invisalign, and over like $1,000 in rewards has we've earned from using that credit card, and then like $200 of returns, I think, that I just didn't reallocate. But anyway, so HELOC. HELOC's at zero. So we're down to just our two student loans on our debt-free journey, and I am so, so happy. I feel so good about this decision. I feel like it was the right decision. We still have over, well, especially, let's see, right now I think we still have over $12,000 between our emergency fund and our sinking funds in our personal money, plus I have $5,000 in my business emergency fund. And then we've got all this access to credit and stuff, and all the stuff I talked about in that video where I was like weighing the pros and cons. So the thing now is that our last two debts have the highest balances. One is at like $85,000, and then the other is at $185,000. So we're not gonna get to do a debt payoff celebration for a while. And so that's why I also really wanted to make this video, because this is just a very special moment, because the next debt payoff celebration is going to be one of our student loans. And it's probably not gonna be for like at least a year, but probably closer to 2 years. And that's okay. I'm totally fine with that. I knew that part was coming, but I'm just really glad to have all the other debt cleared out that we were trying to pay off, and now just be focusing on the student loans. So one thing I wanted to ask you guys is, you know, knowing what you know, that we have about $270,000 of debt, with one having a balance of 185 and the other having a balance of 85,000. How do you think we should celebrate milestones? Like, should we celebrate every $10,000 paid off? Should we celebrate when we hit like another 10% paid off? Or like, what milestones should I be focusing on? Because I definitely need to break this into smaller milestones. Otherwise, I'm just gonna be like throwing money at debt for years and not know when to like celebrate that we hit something. It's just gonna be like, you know, this long, endless journey. So I wanna get really specific in what we're gonna celebrate and break it down, so we can have like tangible goals of little segments of debt that we're working towards, and also know when we can like kind of have mini celebrations along the way and maybe like treat ourselves, reward ourselves for hitting those milestones. So comment below and let me know what you think we should do for celebrating milestones. Like, what increments should we do? Should we do dollar amounts or percentage of debt paid off, or, you know, what do you think makes sense? So that is it for today's video. I just wanted to make like a quick little update telling you guys that we paid off our home equity line of credit. If you follow me on Instagram, you already know all this. And so if you want to follow me on Instagram, it's just at Lauren's Money Mindset. I'll put it right down here. I share with you guys stuff a lot earlier on there, because Instagram is just quick and easy, and like I can in real time almost share stuff with you guys, and then to film a whole video on something and then edit it and get it uploaded takes a lot longer. So if you wanna stay up to date with what's going on in more real time, and also like get a little inside peek into my life more like day to day, I do post stuff on there a little bit more, not a lot. I'm trying to get better at it. But anyway, so follow me on there. I'd love to have you as a follower on there. If you're not subscribed, hit that red subscribe button. I'd love to have you as a subscriber here. If you are excited about this debt payoff update, then give this video a big thumbs up. It really helps on my channel, and I will see you guys soon in my next video. Bye.